सरस्वत्यै नमः ओम श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः ओम समस्त जन कल्याणे निरतं करुणामयं नमामि चिन्मयं देवं सद्गुरुं ब्रह्मविद्वरं सद्गुरुं ब्रह्मविद्वरं ओम शुक्लांबरधरं विष्णुं शशिवर्णं चतुर्भुजं प्रसन्नवदनं ध्यायेत् सर्वविघ्नोपशान्तये व्यासं वसिष्ठनत्तारं शक्ते पौत्रमकल्मषं पराशरात्मजं वन्दे शुकतातन्तपोनिधिं व्यासाय विष्णुरूपाय व्यासरूपाय विष्णवे नमो वै ब्रह्मनिधये वासिष्ठाय नमो नमः वसुदेवसुतं देवं कंसचाणूरमर्दनं देवकी परमानन्दं कृष्णं वन्दे जगद्गुरुं कृष्णं वन्दे जगद्गुरुं ॐ नारायणं नमस्कृत्य नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जयमुदीरयेत् ॐ नमो वसिष्ठाय महाव्रताय पराशरं वेदनिधिं नमस्ये नमोऽस्त्वनन्ताय महोरगाय नमोऽस्तु सिद्धेभ्यैहाक्षयेभ्यः नमोऽस्तु ऋषिभ्यः परमं परेषां देवेषु देवं वरदं वराणाम् सहस्रशीर्षाय नमः शिवाय सहस्रनामाय जनार्दनाय
This is another important question, a wonderful answer. We used to ask a question, what should be the conduct of a king? King means anybody, any administrative leader or anyone. What should be the conduct? Now, what should be the conduct? Or you can say the practices or qualities that he should express as a leader, as a king. So, beautiful one. There are 36 conduct points are given by Bhishmacharya. Very important. Number one, he says, follow dharma. But do not bring harshness in your approach. Number two, be Astika, meaning be a God-fearing man, keep trust on him, the Lord, the Creator. But be friendly with all, meaning even towards those who don't believe in God, you must be equal. Get wealth without resorting to cruel methods. From public or anything, procure wealth, but no cruel method should be involved. Then, four, enjoy objects without crossing the limits of maryada, decency. Five, talk lovingly without bringing dinata in others. Meaning what? When you talk in love, sometimes our talk should not create meekness, helplessness, I am low, मैं बिचारा हूं, दैट काइंड ऑफ फीलिंग शुड नॉट बी जनरेटेड. दैट्स अ ब्यूटी. टॉक लविंगली विदाउट ब्रिंगिंग दीनता इन अदर्स. डू यू गेट माई पॉइंट? डू यू गेट माई पॉइंट और नॉट? ओके. बिकम वैलरस एंड हीरो बट अवॉइड सेल्फ प्रेज. सिक्स्थ वन ओवर. सेवेंथ वन, गिव चैरिटी बट नेवर अपात्र दानम. डोंट गिव टू द वन हु डोंट डिजर्व इट. एट, बी करेजियस बट डोंट बी स्ट्रिंजेंट इन योर एक्शंस एंड वर्ड्स. जब पराक्रम दिखाते हैं डोंट बी स्ट्रिंजेंट, वेरी वेरी रूड एंड श्रूड टॉक. नाइन, अवॉइड कंपनी ऑफ बैड पीपल. टेन, अवॉइड क्वारल्स विथ रिलेटिव्स. इलेवन, डोंट टेक, बिकॉज क्वारल रिलेटिव्स मीन्स वॉट? ऑल दोज अदर किंग्स एंड अदर किंग परिवार, वहां से झगड़ा करेगा तो फिर अगेन दे कैन अटैक यू एट एनी टाइम, दे मे एक्ट अगेंस्ट यू. इलेवेंथ वन, डोंट टेक वर्क फ्रॉम ए पर्सन हु इज नॉट डिवोटेड टू द किंग और द किंगडम. उनसे काम मत लेना जो राजा के प्रति या राज्य के प्रति श्रद्धा नहीं है, उनसे काम मत कभी लेना. ट्वेल्व, गेट योर वर्क डन विदाउट कॉजिंग एनी डिफिकल्टी टू एनीबडी. जब एक से काम ले रहे हो बट शुड नॉट डिस्टर्ब द पीपल अराउंड. ब्यूटिफुल वन. Nowadays in every project there are people are suffering. Do you get my point? No government takes up a project. The people suffer there. The poor people or power or the not the farmers. They suffer a lot because of project. So he says no, take care of that. Don't cause any difficulty to anybody. 13. Never reveal your wishes to wicked people. अपना भाव समझ प्रकट नहीं करना. 14. Never sing your glory to others. सभा में बैठकर या नहीं तो चार पांच लोगों के सामने बैठकर मैंने वैसा किया वैसा किया ऐसा किया नहीं, तो उसी में यू में रिवील सर्टन थिंग्स विच आर नॉट टू बी रिवील्ड. हम बोलते हैं ना बातों बातों में ये भी मुख्य मुंह से निकल गई. निकलना नहीं था एक्चुअली स्पीकिंग बट निकल गया. दैट काइंड ऑफ थिंग विल हैपन. 15th वन, डोंट लूट मनी फ्रॉम द श्रेष्ठ पुरुषास, बेस्ट द पीपल इन सोसाइटी. सपोर्ट देम, हेल्प देम बट डोंट लूट देम. डोंट टेक शेल्टर अंडर नीच पुरुषास. जो गिरा हुआ आदमी का आश्रय मत लेना कभी. तुमसे नीच हो तो उनसे कभी आश्रय मत लेना. 17. विदाउट प्रॉपर इन्वेस्टिगेशन डोंट पनिश एनीबडी. एटीन, कीप सीक्रेट मीटिंग्स सीक्रेट ऑलवेज. डोंट टेल वी हैड ए सीक्रेट मीटिंग यस्टरडे, देन व्हाट सीक्रेट इज देयर इन दैट. 18 हो गया आउट ऑफ 36. और सुनना है आपको 18 सुनना है. डोंट गिव और लेंड मनी टू द ग्रीडी. लोभी लोगों को पैसा मत देना, वो वापस नहीं देगा. इन द फॉर्म ऑफ लोन्स डोंट गिव. 20th, डोंट ट्रस्ट एनीवन who had caused you apakaram or harm, who has harmed you even once. ये एक बार राजा को कुछ नुकसान या नहीं तो दुख पहुंचाया, उन पर दोबारा भरोसा मत रखो पूरा. राजा cannot play because he cannot take risk. It is not his risk, it is risk of people, citizen, country. So she very careful. 20th over. 21st, protect your women. Respect women. That's why Shastra mein kaha gaya, and everywhere, either you see women as mother if you are a man, or a daughter or a sister. And that's actually not a difficult also. If you're really pure, as similar women towards men, attitudes. So if you really practice that understanding, pure love, you don't harm anybody. मैं और एक बात कह देता हूँ, लोगों को प्यार करते 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 गिविंग लव टू एवरीबडी, यू मे लूज इन दैट प्रोसेस, बिकॉज द काइंड ऑफ लव यू पोर इन, पीपल मे नॉट बी एलिजिबल टू रिसीव इट, सो दे मे दे फॉरगेट इट एंड देन दे मे नॉट रेसिप्रोकेट. सपोज naughty children or indisciplined children are there. They keep on receiving love from parents, but they never reciprocate. कल कभी पल लेके जाएंगे, कभी कपड़ा दिलाएंगे मम्मी पापा को, कभी ये सेवा करेंगे, कभी उनको यात्रा पे जा रहे हैं उनको ये सेवा करेंगे, उनको अच्छा रखेंगे, उनको अच्छा बहुत सारा सुविधाएं देंगे. Comfort, let us comfort them. Sensitivity, both girls or boys towards parents, I'm talking. So that is missing. So protection, as a king you should protect women. Okay. Next one. King should be, 22nd one. King should be pure, but Droṇa or hate should be avoided. Meaning, I am pure, so I start hating others who are not pure. The same Vairagya. Vairagya also what? Suppose I have developed Vairagya, dispassion towards coffee or something else, or I don't have any thought for smoking or drinking. So I developed Vairagya towards these things, dispassion towards these things. But what happens? I start unknowingly hating those people who take to smoking, who take to drinking. So हम जो कहते हैं वैराग्य वैराग्य, उसमें हमारा द्वेष भी प्रकट हो रहा है अंतर्वाहिनी के रूप में लोगों के प्रति. जो अपना मन के साथ सहमत नहीं है, राय के साथ सहमत नहीं है, उनके प्रति द्वेष. यू ऑब्जर्व दिस, आई डोंट लाइक इट, दैट इज रॉन्ग. आई बिलीव इन गॉड, आई हेट ऑल दोज हु डोंट बिलीव इन गॉड. Similarly, king should be pure, but Droṇa or hate should be avoided. 22 or over. Then, 23rd one. Don't spend more time with women in the palace, gossip surrounding by women, joking with them, talking with them. So you forget, it's an habit. So you forget all those. So these are bad habits. So be careful. 24th. Take pure and healthy food. Avoid food which causes harm to the body. So that's very important. You should be healthy. So be careful. 25th one. Give up pride and serve respectable people in society with humility. I am Raja, I am the great, I am this, I am that. Go chodke. Serve respectable people with humility. Service without humility is not a service at all. It is a sort of arrogance. If I don't do this to you, if I had not helped you, what would have been your condition? Bakwas. 25 over, 26. Serve gurus without any hypocrisy. Guru Droha is a beautiful article written by Swami Chidrupanandaji. Guru is innocent, I tell you. Real guru jo hai, real means not a kapda vesh dharam baithe baithe aisa nahi hai jo guru bolte rehte hain. Real teacher, great teachers are always pure, and in a way they are innocent. Innocent means what? They don't want to judge people from the plane in from which we normally ordinary people judge others. उनके सामने सभी लोग प्यारे हैं, सभी लोग बच्चे हैं, सब लोग अच्छे हैं. But then when we serve gurus, we doubt them. It's very difficult to surrender to guru. Unconditional. Even you cannot understand with your intellect the action of a master, you must say, I trust him, I love him. There must be some reason why my guru did this. So I don't want to question. I don't want to analyze. I don't want to ask anything. So in life, don't search for a perfect guru. Why? Because recognition of perfection is possible only when you are perfect. So I can't recognize perfection if I am not perfect. So serve gurus without any hypocrisy, kapata, saying something, keeping something inside, planning to bring troubles to guru. If you have seen in history, it's a risk. From the standpoint of a teacher, to allow everybody to come near him, to talk to them freely, to guide them, to love them, in a way it is risky. But they have no fear from higher dimension. It's a beautiful point. 27th one, avoid dambha, dikhavati, showing something which is not, without dambha, meaning, ab dekhiye, so many in the society, in the world, they take up some activities with dambha. The way they announce their donations in the public, or the way they behave, or the way they perform puja, yajna, havan, etc. with a huge pomp and show. So a raja without dambha, Bhishmajaji says, do puja of devatas. Worship without dambha, dambha shadam de, like my raja hu. So that kind of a ritual or a puja mein hi dambha a jata hai. So without dambha, puja do. 27th over. 28. Don't desire to gain wealth through censured means, illegal means. Don't try to fill your treasury through wrong means of procedures or policies. That is not correct. 29. Give up obstinacy and practice love. जिद्दी मत बनना, सबके प्रति प्यार से व्यवहार करो. 30th, be a karya kushala, a very efficient in all works. At the same time, don't behave untimely. See, so samayochita vyavaharam, samaya anusar, samay ke anusar, desh ke anusar, as per the requirement. So be efficient, but don't behave untimely. 31. Don't show compassion or don't comfort anybody just to release someone from bondage. Look, suppose somebody has made a mistake. He is in jail. A king should not show compassion and show them escape routes. People will watch. Today, you are very clearly seeing, we are seeing, same crime committed by an ordinary man, same crime committed by a so-called reputed in society. Punishment may be announced, pronounced same punishment by two different sitting judges or judges panel, but one would get bail mysteriously, one will not get it, as though other has given chance. Suppose you are punished and to be jailed for 7 years, as though he has a choice. Whenever he is free, he can go and sit in jail and come back. As per his convenience, he can go to jail and come out. Is it striking what I am talking about? So a king should not show this kind of compassion. Beautiful one. 32. Do not censure or be sarcastic at the time of showing your compassion on somebody. So wonderful point. See, when we give some compassion towards anybody, हम जब दान देते हैं या कुछ दया दिखा रहे हैं, दैट मे दैट एक्शन व्हाट वी डू समटाइम्स वी टेंड टू बिकम सरकास्टिक. अब पता लगा मेरे इंपॉर्टेंस, लो पैसा लो जाओ. नो यू अंडरस्टूड माई वैल्यू, नो यू आस्क मी क्वेश्चंस, आई विल आंसर यू, बट आई लव यू आर. सो सरकास्टम इज ब्रिलियंट पॉइंट्स. सो डोंट सेंश्योर और बी सरकास्टिक एट द टाइम ऑफ शोइंग योर कंपैशन ऑन समबडी. 32 ओवर. 33. डू नॉट स्ट्राइक, अटैक और पनिश एनीबडी विदाउट नोइंग देम. फर्स्ट फाइंड आउट. Don't listen here and there and start acting. King should not act like that. 34. Do not lament after killing the enemies, which Yudhishthira has been doing. After finishing off the enemies, don't lament. Done it, done, that's it. 34 over. 35. Do not show sudden gush of anger on anybody. Achanak, akaran, gussa. Raja mat dikhana hai. Achanak gussa dikhayenge, parents towards children. And many times it happened, children become so sensitive, they went and commit suicide. Sudden gush of anger is very dangerous. How many left? only one. 36, he says, be komal, that is, be tender, flexible, calm, but not towards those who do apakaram, meaning those who cause injury, damage or harm. Don't be too flexible, too calm and tender towards them. Be strict. Always. These are the 36 code of conduct for any leader mentioned here. Achha laga? 36. Next question. Yudhishthira asked, how could a king, how is it possible for a king to avoid chinta, worry? And also, how can a king avoid mistakes while practicing dharma? So Bhishma simply briefly explained and he mentions, dharma is inexhaustible, it is always fresh, eternal, it won't end, it will be always there. Then he said, a king who with the support of kama and krodha wants to earn money, fill treasury, become rich, make the country progress under the attack of kama and krodha, gussa mein ya insisting desire ke saath. Yadi karna chahte hai, such a person, he neither gets dharma nor does wealth stay with him. Beautiful point. Then he says, don't give any financial control to a person who is a murkha, a fool, but a kami, lot of desires he has, and a lobhi. Kami, murkha, kami aur lobhi ko, jisme aur jinme ye tino gun saath mein hai, unko kabhi financial control mat dena. Then another point he said, Yudhishthira, you should be like a gardener. What does gardener do? Protects the plants and trees. But don't be a collier. Collier means that coal banane wala. Koila banane wala. Wo kya karega? Jungle mein sabhi ped ko, vruksh ko kaat ke, jala ke usse koil banata hai. Koila. So don't be a collier like this. Gardener protects. He may trim the plants. But the man who wants coal, he completely burns. So don't be like a such person where you wanted to suck everything and use it and convert everything into energy. Money. Or anything into return on. Everything is return. That is wrong. Now having said these things, Bhishmacharya continues. He says, a king should appoint a Vidwan Brahmana. Meaning, Brahmana means it is indicated in God, Rishi also, Muni also, or one who is wise, intelligent, dedicated, pure, Sattva Guna Pradhana, works for society, evolution of mankind only works, is very disciplined, dedicated, spiritual in his thinking, selfless, loving everybody. So, ye bar 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 main kehte aa raha hu. Brahmana means this is the Brahmana. So, a Raja should appoint a Vidwan Brahmana, a well-educated Shastri, Pandit ko, should appoint as one's purohit. Asthana purohita. Raja's purohit. Then Bhishma Jaji said, there was a dialogue between Ila Kumara, that is Pururava, and Vayudeva. Sometime back it happened. So Pururava asked a question. He said, Maharaj, O Vayudeva, what is the origin or from where does a Brahmana is born? Similarly, how did other Varnas were born? What was their origin? So this you know, Purushuttam. That thought is mentioned here. Brahmanosya Mukamasit, Bahu Rajanyakrutaha, Uru Tadasya Dvaishaha, Padbhyam Sudro Ajayata. That's it. So Brahmanas are born from the face of Brahmaji, Mukha, Kshatriyas from his arms, Vaishyas from his thighs, and Shudras are from creator's feet only. Now he said, Vayudeva said, with regards to the protection of dharma, dharma rakshana bharme karya bharme, it is a brahmana who controls other varnas. Niyanta banta hai. Mane, in the society, the values system, existence of value system, their flourishment or their nourishment, their flourishing, etc., are in the hands of Brahmanas. Brahmana Vritti is teacher also. At least while you are teaching, every teacher should be like a Brahmana. At the time of teaching, at least. Brahmana thought ko apnana padega. Of this purity what I mentioned. Then he said, so that means what? It is the responsibility of Brahmanas to see that the value systems are spread. How? Through his knowledge, wisdom, teachings, sharing with other, his experiences with others, bringing to the cognition of the people about subtle things which are otherwise otherwise impossible for anybody to know on their own. That is a Brahmana's job. Then he said, Pururava asked, ye bataye, is Prithvi belonging to whom? Does it belong to Brahmana or does it belong to Dharmataha? Dharmadrushtya, if you see, this Prithvi ke upar kiska adhikari hai, adhikaritva. Mane right. Whom to whom does this earth belong to? Does it belong to a Brahmana or Kshatriya? Belong to means not ownership as you are thinking, mera property and all, registration office and all. Not that way. Who would be the real person on the earth? That means, does it belong to the intelligent, wise people, learned people, evolved people of first class? Or does it belong to the administrative class, ruling class? Whom does this earth belong to? Vayuruvacha, Vayudeva said, Raja, the knowers of dharma, dharmajna purushas, the one who knows dharma, people who knew dharma, it is their opinion and they accept it in principle very clearly that whatever is on earth, it all belongs to a brahmana. Brahmana means, again this character. Why? Because ultimately, all mankind, because what is the problem with mankind, tell me? Intellect. Animals and plants have no that kind of a knowledge or capacity to destroy the earth of its resources. Who is the destroyer on earth? Mankind. Why? Because they have intellect. Intellect. But misguided, never guided, impure, dirty logic, dry reasoning. Therefore, here he very clearly said, ultimately, the earth, since all mankind is spread, mankind is having intellect, but majority of those intellects are not under good condition, stable condition, wise condition. Very disruptive, volatile, agitated, unpleasant. Now such intellects are to be ruled by, if they want to survive the earth, the other species, and also if you want to guide mankind, it has to necessarily come under supreme intelligentsia. It is the intelligence which can really rule, it is the intelligence which can really guide. That intelligence which integrates the mankind. That intelligence which, what you call, prospers, creates prosperity on earth. Intelligence which does not harm any species or anything in nature. Intelligence which balances the forces of nature, which stabilizes the ecology. So that is called intelligent living. And how can we live intelligently without being guided in intelligence? And who can guide us? The very intelligent people, maharshis, rishis, wise people, contemplative seers in all walks of life, those who are sensitive enough towards their heart, towards the culture, towards the ecology, nature. And they are the ones who can really guide mankind. Therefore, this earth belongs to intelligent people and not to the rulers. They are the real policy makers. An uneducated, illiterate person is elected and becomes a MP and then a minister also in cabinet. He is guided by whom? On his own? By his intelligence? Somebody intelligent he appoints, an IAS officer or somebody who knew, who studied well. If he is really pure, he gets a credit. Mantri. If Mantri is bad, he also bad. Or if Mantri is weak, now what is happening now? Whether weak or strong, they are dictated, they are suppressed. Where good people are there, they are suppressed. And they decide, no, aisa karna padega. And they all of them are in Tihar jail now. Scams. So therefore, it belongs to Brahmana, he said. Why? Vayu says, without doubt, it is a Brahmana who is a guru, who is jeshtha, is a firstborn, elder. So elder ko hi milna chahiye. Mane not control. This entire system can be, they can guide the intelligence of the intelligentsia, not dry intelligentsia, not dry intellectuals of our understanding. But what I said, as mentioned before, they are jeshta and they are sreshta among all the varnas, all the people. Therefore, it should be under the guidance and it belongs to them. They can dictate terms, they can guide mankind, they can flourish, make everybody flourish. Because we are irrational animals, so we are supposed to be rational animals, irrationally behaving, so we are to be controlled by higher intelligence. It's a beautiful question. Then, afterwards, Bhishmacharya continues. He says, a purohita, who is a dharmatma, and a right kind of right advisor to the king, and the king with good qualities. This combination is good, meaning a raja with good qualities and a purohita who is a dharmatma and a right kind of advisor. Who is Purohita? Purasya hitam yo kankshati. Pura means town, village, people. One who wishes the welfare of all sections of people is called Purohita. So therefore, he is a Dharmatma Purohita and a right advisor plus and the king with good qualities. This combination is good for whom? Both for the king and also for the Praja. This combination is missing. Right combination. Wherever there is a right minister, right chief minister or prime minister, and right kind of bureaucracy around him, and see how beautifully that government governance would come out. A king without a purohit is impure. So beautiful it is. A Raja who has no purohit, that's why every house we used to have that purohita. Amara purohit. For all functions, he is advisor. Everything he advises. Not occasionally. And such purohitas are taken care by families. Every month they give some dakshina. Every month. And any function in their house, any consultation required. Our ghar pe theek, ghar par logon ka health theek nahi hai. To kya karna chahiye? Kya karne se shanti milti hai? Ab ye dosh hai, wo dosh hai. Toh hamara man mein ye ho raha hai. Hamare kandan mein ye naya bachcha aaya. Unka namakaran sharmani, annaprasana, aur upanayana. Or vivaha, or any other function. Please guide us. Wo culture hi hat gaya hamare se. Now what do you look at Purohit means? A milking man. That's the right kind of Purohits always tell that Swamiji Shraddha se puja karna karane wala bahut kam ho gaya. हम लिस्ट देंगे, लिस्ट में से आधा काट के रख देंगे, बोलते हैं कि बस वो नहीं लाया, कैसे भी अब संभाल लेना. दीप जलाने के लिए मैच बॉक्स नहीं है, नहीं चला देना काम. सो वी डोंट, एटलीस्ट वी शुड स्टार्ट समवेयर, नो. इफ लोगों में श्रद्धा है तो पुरोहित विल बिकम सो एक्स्ट्रा श्रद्धा. जैसे लोगों में श्रद्धा नहीं, हम इसलिए suppose if you insist, people insist that yeah, we want this, we want learned people, then everybody will learn. So I don't insist my purohit who comes to me, for example, I say that theek hai, puja karna hai, kitne der hogi sir, ye sara puja karne ke liye 2 ghante 2.5 ghanta lagega. No, 2.5 ghanta hamare paas time nahi hai, bas 15 minute mein khatam karke chale jana. Ha chale jayenge 15 minute mein. So who is spoiling them? So they get used to shortcut methods. So logon mein shraddha yadi nahi hai, how can you expect good people around you if you don't have shraddha? Suppose if I insist only qualified person is required as my personal assistant or secretary, and uncompromisingly I choose only this man, learned man only required, then everybody will learn. Instead of that, we are not a Shraddha, we blame them. And they say that a logon Shraddha nahi. A whole system is collapsed. So this combination, who is the combination? A right advisor and a right king is good for both citizens and a king without a Purohit is impure. Because pata nahi wo kya karta hai. So what does a Purohit do? He says he advises the king. A Purohit means an advisor. An IAS officer or IPS officer who is just around them. a learned man in this case. What does a Purohita do? A Purohit should be Shrestha than Raja. Raja se badkar Purohit honi chahiye in knowledge and wisdom and tapas shakti. In his thought structure, purity of the mind, clarity in the intellect. He says here, Shreyan Rajanaha Purohitaha. A Purohit should be Shreyan, meaning a superior to the king. And Bhishmacharya says, the coordination between a Purohit and the Raja is the most vital thing for the welfare of the citizens. Apna ghar mein le lo aap. If you have all to faltu logo as advisors around you, ghar ka pura satyanash karke baithenge log. Who are our advisors? Uneducated, illiterate, foolish neighbors for ready-made solutions. My husband is troubling me, what should I do? One lady asked her neighbor. She suggested divorce. As a faltu, bekar logon ko hum bana ke rakhte hain around. Aajkal paisa mil nahi raha hai, kya karna hai? Imandari se kamaya nahi ja raha hai. Kya karna hai? Na kala danda shuru kar lo. Who are we, our advisors? Illiterate, meaning uneducated, unintelligent, ignorant people around us who claim themselves to be our well-wishers or our advisors. Yes or no? Zor se bolna, kya sharam aate aapko? Yes or no? अरे एक समस्या यदि सामने आ गए, हम इस समस्या का समाधान या परिष्कार के लिए या न तो समाधान के लिए जवाब के लिए इसका किससे पूछना, वो भी नहीं हम नहीं जानते. किसके पास जाना है इस समस्या का समाधान के लिए? किसके पास जाना है हमें वो भी पता नहीं. सामने कुत्ता तो कुत्ता से पूछते हैं. That is our intelligence. So, in this regard, that is combination between a right king and a right minister. In this regard, there was a dialogue between Pururava again and Maharshi Kashyapa. Bhishmacharya quotes. So, Pururava asked, if a Brahman leaves the king, suppose ek Brahmana Raja ko tyag diya, ya nahi to Raja Brahman ko tyag diya, chod diya, left a Brahmana, meaning chod diya. Then whom should citizens approach for shelter? Raja ke paas jana hai ya Brahman ke paas jana hai? Bureaucracy and the law and order maintain karne wala police and other protective forces, security agencies and forces in our country. If there is no coordination between them, what kind of security we can offer to the country? This should be the course for IAS and IPS, ministers, MLA. They should pass test on these things to become first MLA or MP. This is a qualification. Not getting votes by force from illiterate people. And our intelligent society, so-called intelligent people never vote. Educated class never vote, poor people only vote. An educated class will take their drink and a cup of coffee or tea or go on picnic on election day. And these are the ones who claim big, tall, make tall claims when society is not good, country is not good. In some of the some youth camp or somewhere, some youngster asked me, I just asked, very good, you are raising a lot of issues. Did you vote? He said, no. Then shut up and sit down, I said. the prime responsibility yesterday we saw, first responsibility to elect a king. You have no right to talk about country if you are not participated in electoral process. Now if I don't find anybody, then there is an option also in the ballot paper. Access that option. So this is the question asked. Purvurava asked. Kiske paas, log kiske paas jayenge? Kashyapa said, when Brahmana and Kshatriya become strong only when they are together, they become strong only when they are together. Meaning, our political class, intelligent political class should be there, plus the bureaucracy who is next to them. If both of them are good and good coordination is there between them, then alone it is good and they become strong. Only politicians without bureaucracy help, or only bureaucracy without politicians, this one, king rulers, not our kind of cheap politicians I am talking about. Right kind of elected representatives of our country, then only things will happen. So Kashyapa says, if for any reason, kisi karan, a Brahmana leaves the Kshatriya, or Kshatriya if he leaves a Brahmana, to whom citizens can approach, what will happen? Ab pata nahi kya hoga tab? He said, thieves take charge of such a kingdom. अभी आपको मैं वर्तमान में जो हो रहा है आई नो देयर इज नो कोऑपरेशन कोऑर्डिनेशन बिटवीन देम एंड नो ब्यूरोक्रेट पीपल आर सो स्केयर्ड ऑफ टेकिंग डिसीजंस दे डोंट वांट टू कमिट बिकॉज दे विल बी पनिश्ड हॉन्टेड सो दे नोबडी वांट टू बी रेस्पॉन्सिबल. So, thieves take charge of such a kingdom when there is no coordination between Brahmana and a Kshatriya. When Kshatriya gives up a Brahmana, Kshatriya, yadi, king, administrative class, the ruling class, very important point. If they give up Brahmanas, meaning they don't respect and revere and care or adore or accept the wonderful people in society, they are ignored and considered as fools and therefore tyagriya, tab kya hoga? Then Kshatriya cannot get education, children cannot grow. Padhane ka kaam kiska hai? Ab Brahman ko tyag diya. You will be deprived of Swadhyaya, Veda Jnanam, knowledge to your Santana, children. Education will be lost. Now what happened now? What's happening? Every textbook or every education, whatever it is politicized. Politicized syllabus. Do you agree with me? That means we are given up Brahmanas, the right kind of intelligent people are there, where the value system, character building, education, that is not there, never taught, life knowledge is not given, only academic knowledge, information is given for like livelihood, trampling upon others, false glamour, false prestige is given value by parents and society today. Even parents are so scared of children now. What is a children? 5th class, 6th class, they darte hain unse. What kind of nonsense your parent comes and tells me that my son is about 7-year-old, 8-year-old, he is suffering from peer pressure. Huh? What is peer pressure? No, everybody has some huge gadgets, so my son also asking. What is the cost of it? 50,000. Can he handle it? I don't know. But very important it is for him. Psychologically to strengthen him, very important. Are you strengthening or weakening? Slap, give them, nothing will be given. Mahābhārata Śānti Parva mein bhi mereko mauka milta hai Rājadharma Parva mein daantne ka. Maanduki mein main kya daantu aapko? Omkar, amakar, ukar, makar, amatra. Amatra mein pahunch gaya to kuch nahi hai. Ab main kahan daantu? To Bhagwan ne hamare liye kabhi kabhi aisa mauka dete hai. Therefore, children cannot grow, education will collapse. So, Brahmana and Kshatriya should always coordinate themselves together in coordination, should work. Similarly, if Brahmana gives up Kshatriya, I don't want Raja. I don't want King. Raja ko tyag diya. Tab kya hoga? Then he cannot pursue yajna karmas, yaga karma. Paisa kaun dega? Suppose if I give up you, where will I get food from? If you give me up, where will you get knowledge? Me means not individual, teacher. You means not you. Audience, srota or vakta. Wonderful, wonderful, wonderful. So, yajna karne ke liye, yaga karne ke liye, swadhyaya karne ke liye, ashram banane ke liye, paisa kahan se milta hai? Even ashrama is not supported by king giving food for a brahmachari, vatus. The students in the ashram, so many thousands of people used to stay in ashrama sometimes. How to feed them? So Raja used to supply. Hamara Rajya mein jitne jitne gurukul hain, un sabhi mahatmaon ko sab every month itna chawal, itna gehu, itna doodh, itne gaay, chalo dete raho, gaay de do saal mein ek baar. Sabji, gibji, sab de do. Some they cultivate, some extra support from the king. So Raja used to pump for the strengthening of the character of the people of the kingdom through education. So, Brahmana unko chod diya, Kshatriya ko ye problem hai. Kshatriya Brahman ko chod diya, wo aur ek problem hai. To saath mein milkar kaam karo. Then Kashyapa says, is when more papis are manifesting on earth, ye coordination bilkul nahi ho raha hai, papis are increasing, sinners are increasing, then what will happen? Kashyapa says, then Rudra Bhagavan will manifest. Destroy. Then Pururva said, another question, that Maharaj, in this world sun shines equally on papi and punyatmas also. Papatma ke upar bhi punya equal shining. Vayu also supports equally. Earth also supports both papi and punyavan. So everybody supporting. Kashyapa says, this is there only in this world. And worldwide, this kind of a thing existing in different other lokas also. This kind of papi punya together they exist. But they should be, papi should be controlled, punyatma dharmatma should be encouraged. This is the eternal story, it continues. Jaise ki koi humme se koi nahi keh sakta, humme se mane koi aadmi nahi keh sakta ki main swaas lete lete thak gaya. Tab kya hoga? बहुत बार ले चुका हूं श्वास, थके नहीं आप? और रोज ब्रेकफास्ट लंच डिनर श्रद्धा पूर्वक श्रद्धा विश्वास रूपेण हो ताभ्याम माने ब्रेकफास्ट और लंच के बिना न पश्यन्ति बुधरम जीवन विधानम न पश्यन्ति therefore we are regularly eating so can we say we are tired of eating chalte rehta papi punya but this is dharma should establish okay next bhishma Charya continues. One or two points we will see here. Then I will stop. Only half of it we will see. Yeah. He says, O Raja, O Yudhishthira, the welfare of the citizens is in the hands of the king. But the king's welfare is in the hands of Purohit. Beautiful one. Another point, excellent point to remember. What does a Brahmana do? A Brahmana removes unknown fear. Adrushta bhayam nikalne wala Brahman hota hai. Adrushta, drushta means seen. Adrushtam, unknown, unseen, unnoticed. Some kind of bhaya with respect to future. So Brahmana removes the unknown fear and Raja removes the drushta bhayam, meaning known fear, tangible, intangible, perceptible, imperceptible, visible, invisible, noticeable, unnoticeable. So ye Brahman ka kaam hai अदृष्ट भयम को निकालने वाला मीनिंग अनसीन फियर राजा का काम क्या है दृष्ट भयम को हटाना है हटाएगा सो व्हेन ए ब्राह्मणा रिमूव्स द अननोन फियर अदृष्ट भयम व्हेन ए किंग रिमूव्स द दृष्ट भयम दोनों अपना अपना काम कर रहे हैं सच ए किंगडम कीप्स ऑन ग्रोइंग एंड प्रोग्रेसिंग इन देयर प्रॉस्पेरिटी इसके ऊपर हम वर्कशॉप कर सकते हैं Every one of us has this fear, known fear, unknown fear. In this regard, people quote a dialogue between Raja Muchukunda and Kubera. It was said that Raja Muchukunda, after conquering the whole world, earth, उन्होंने क्या किया? सारा पृथ्वी को जीत लेने के बाद, माने having conquered so many places. टू टेस्ट हिज पावर चलो मैंने सारा पृथ्वी और मेरा बल मेरे मुझ में बल कितना है ये जानने के लिए ही वेंट एंड अटैक्ड कुबेर राजा मुचुकुंद तब क्या होगा हम कल देखेंगे ओम पूर्णमदः पूर्णमिदं पूर्णात् पूर्णमुदच्यते पूर्णस्य पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते ओम शांति 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 हरि ओम श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः हरि ओम सद्गुरुनाथ महाराज की जय